الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وحبيبه أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق فبلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة وجاهد في الله حتى أتاه اليقين فجزاك الله يا سيدي يا رسول الله عنا وعن المسلمين جميعًا خير الجزاء نشهد أنك قد بلغت الرسالة وأديت الأمانة ونصحت للأمة ومحوت الغمة وجاهدت في الله حتى أتاك اليقين اللهم اجزه عنا وعن المسلمين جميعا خير الجزاء اللهم اجعلنا ممن يردون عليه الحوض ولا يردون ولا تجعلنا ممن يردون فيردون اللهم اسقنا بيد نبينا شربة هنيئة مريئة لا نضمأ بعدها أبدا يا رب العالمين من كان يريد لقاء الله فإن أجل الله لآت ومن جاهد فإنما يجاهد لنفسه إن الله لغني عن العالمين والذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات ليكفرن عنهم سيئاتهم وليجزينهم أحسن الذي كانوا يعملون ومن يعمل من الصالحات من ذكر أو أنثى وهو مؤمن فلنحيينه حياة طيبة ولنجزينهم أجرهم بأحسن الذي كانوا يعملون All praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Those whom Allah guides are rightly guided I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He will accept us among those whom He has guided I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He will affirm the deen in our hearts and that He will give us the yaqeen in the hereafter and that he will allow us to die on the state of belief Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam كان من أكثر دعائه most of his dua He used to say, يا مقلب القلوب والأبصار ثبت قلبي على دينك. Oh Allah, the one who is in charge of the hearts, the one who is in charge of the sight, of the seeing, affirm my heart on your deen. Because subhanAllah, sometimes your eyes might desire something other than Allah. Might desire some of this dunya that will lead you away from Allah. And the eye is like the tool or the apparatus to the heart. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he used to say, Oh Allah, who has control over the hearts and the sight, affirm my heart on your deen. I bear testimony that there is no one that's worthy of worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of heaven and earth, the maintainer, the sustainer of everything. And I bear testimony that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is his servant and last messenger. He is his last prophet and last messenger. There is no prophets nor messengers after Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Do not be fooled, my dear Muslim brothers and sisters. Somebody might claim, and we know there are groups who claim that there is messengers after Rasulullah. And they put it in such a beautiful way. It looks so nice. They are mujaddid. The mujaddid is not a messenger, is not a prophet. Somebody who revives the religion follows the exact words of the religion without proclaiming prophethood or messengerhood. So those false, the Dajjalin, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam talks about, there will be more than 30 Dajjal. Dajjal means liar. And Dajjal is exaggerated liar, because they are lying in regard to the religion. Those are liars. They are not mujaddideen, they are not revivers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, من كان يريد لقاء الله فإن أجل الله لآت. Subhanallah, whoever wishes the meeting of his Lord, that meeting for sure will take place, and it's very near. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, قِيَامَةُ أَحَدِكُمْ يَوْمَ مَوْتِهِ. Subhanallah, so I don't have to await the day of judgment. My day of judgment is the day when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala permits the angel of death to take my life. That's my day of judgment. قِيَامَةُ أَحَدِكُمْ يَوْمَ مَوْتِهِ. Our deeds will vanish, will stop, will not continue after we die, only from three sources according to the hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam: a good son or daughter that makes dua for you, a charity that you have left behind, building a masjid as beautiful as this one, mashallah, or establishing a clinic or a hospital, or maybe digging a well in Africa where the people need the water. These are continuous charities. Or عِلْمٌ يُنْتَفَعُ بِهِ. عِلْمٌ يُنْتَفَعُ بِهِ. Can you imagine somebody as example like Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyya or Ibn Taymiyyah radiallahu anhum, or maybe Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, the knowledge that he left behind, they will receive deeds for until the day of judgment. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَمَنْ جَاهَدَ فَإِنَّمَا يُجَاهِدُ لِنَفْسِهِ. He says, and whoever struggles, he struggles for himself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it very clear in the hadith Qudusi, لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم كانوا على أتقى قلب رجل فيكم ما زاد ذلك في ملكي شيئا. If all of you, mankind and jinnkind, from the beginning to the end, were as pious as the best one of you, that will not increase the dominion of Allah a tiny bit. لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم كانوا على أفجر قلب رجل فيكم ما نقص ذلك من ملكي شيئا. And he, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, says, and if all of you, mankind and jinnkind, from the beginning of time until the end, were as bad as the worst one of you, that will not decrease my dominion a tiny bit. إنما هي أعمالكم أحصيها لكم ثم أوفيكم إياها. I am merely gathering your deeds. I record it and I judge you based on what you have advanced, based on what you have put forth. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَمَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا فَلِنَفْسِهِ وَمَنْ أَسَاءَ فَعَلَيْهَا. Whoever do righteous is for himself, and whoever do wrong or evil is on himself. So, subhanallah, if we have fardiyat al-jaza, you will be asked as an individual. وَكُلٌّ آتِيهِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فَرْدًا إِن كُلُّ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ إِلَّا آتِي الرَّحْمَانِ عَبْدًا لَقَدْ أَحْصَاهُمْ وَعَدَّهُمْ عَدًّا وَكُلُّهُمْ آتِيهِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فَرْدًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another ayah, وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِنَ الصَّالِحَاتِ وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ فَلَنُحْيِيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبَةً. Whoever do righteous deeds as a believer, of course, belief, you could do as much as you want. Without the belief, it means nothing. It means nothing. You have to have the tawheed. You have to have la ilaha illallah. And he says, whoever do righteous deeds, man or woman, male or female, and he is a believer, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guarantees for him a haya tayyiba, a good life, pure life, beautiful life, life full of serenity, of comfort, life full of righteousness, of truthfulness. You feel happy, you go to sleep at night and you are comfortable. You don't feel at night worried. What did I do to that man? Poor guy, I just signed a contract that took his money. Or I just charged him extra as a doctor. Or I just falsified documents. You will have a pure life where you feel the comfort of your action. Whoever do righteous deeds, man or woman, and he is a believer, Allah will give him a good life in this dunya. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them ajr in the akhirah. But the ajr will not be measured on the small deeds they do, in the highest level of deeds that they have accomplished. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, وَإِنَّ أَحَدَكُمْ لَيَرَى آثَارِ. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, the one of you will see the traces of the ma'asiyah in the manner of his horse. Subhanallah. You commit a sin, you dwell into the disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you go in the morning, there's a flat tire. You go in the morning, the car will not start. Or you will be stopped by the police and $250 ticket. This is the cheapest one nowadays. I have not taken one ticket in the past 3 years, I promise. It's not because, I just know, I have children. So he says, Allah, Rasulullah says, you will find the traces of your ma'asiyah in the behavior of your horse. You will find the traces of your ma'asiyah in the conduct of your children. Do not blame these children. You commit a sin that is going to reflect in the manners of your wife, of your children, of the horse you ride, or the car you ride, in the dealing that you execute. So the haya tayyiba is going to come out of what? Of the good deed. Now let me just elaborate a little bit more, because when I was digging through the tafsir of this particular ayah, what is haya tayyiba? What do we consider a good life as believers? If you were to ask me this question before I read all this, I would say having a nice house, a new car, having a bunch of kids who are going to be doctors, not engineers. I'm an engineer, unemployed. Doctors, because those are the only ones who are working nowadays. What is حياة طيبة? Is it all these measures that we put out? That we think? Is the حياة طيبة by putting the words out we speak? We talk sometimes so beautiful. We proclaim so many things, but in reality it's not there. It's not in our heart. We talk big. What's the حياة طيبة? Listen to what how the ulama of the ummah gave us the meanings of حياة طيبة. They said number one, استقرار النفوس لحسن وعد الله تعالى. When you feel so much confident in your heart that whatever Allah has promised and revealed unto you in the Quran is the truth. Look at the ummah nowadays. حتى إذا استيأس الرسل. Look at the ummah nowadays. Everywhere you look. Killing, destruction, knowingly avoiding the word of La ilaha illallah. We have a new wave of secular systems. Remember 50 years ago we had communism. Knowingly they are hurting, they are afflicting the believers with harm. But you as a believer, you will have that constant feeling that whatever Allah has promised is haqq. Look at Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Look at the companions. In the fight of the ditch, the Khandaq, a rock, big rock, comes in the way of the believers. They couldn't break it. Who did they seek help with? Rasulullah. Ya Rasulullah, help us. He takes the axe. He hits the first hit and a spark comes out. He says, Allahu Akbar, futihat li abwaab Roma. Allah is the greatest. Allahu Akbar, the Roman emperor has failed or fallen beneath me. The second hit and one third of the rock broke. The second one, he says, Allahu Akbar, the Persian emperor, the Persian country, civilization has fallen beneath my feet. And the third one, he says, Allahu Akbar, futihat li abwaabul Yaman. Subhanallah. If you look for a second, where is he? In Medina. Surrounded by what? By the Ahzab, all the allies. All the allies from every corner in the world. They came at that time to kill them, to destroy them fully inside their homeland, which is a small city of Medina. And here he says, Allahu Akbar, Persia has opened. He's like imagining conquering Persia and Rome and Yemen. If the Sahaba had any doubt in their heart, they would say, what is he talking about? جاي تقيم الدين في مالطا. In Arabic, that's what we say. You're trying to establish the religion in Malta. In other words, what? It's a joke. Nobody will ever think for a second that Islam could come back and we could revive it again and the Khilafah could be re-established. And believe me, my dear Muslim brothers, the time is nowadays. The time is nowadays for the Khilafah to be re-established, inshallah. So he says, you have to have the heart to be totally confident in the promises of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the fight of Badr, if you all recall the story, he sat down under the arish, under the hut, and he raised his hand to the degree it was so high, حتى بان بياض إبطه. The whiteness of under his arm showed. That means exaggeration of the dua. Ya Rabb, Ya Rabb, Ya Rabb, innaka in tuhlik hadhihi al-usba falan tu'bada fil ard. If this usba, this ummah, this group of Muslims, 314 people around him, you will not be worshipped in this earth. And he's making dua. And Abu Bakr, he says, Ya Rasulallah, ba'id munashadataka rabbak fa inna allaha munjizun ma wa'adak. O Rasulallah, enough. Because he saw the heart of Rasulullah is almost getting out of his chest. Because he's crying to Allah. Nowadays, la ilaha illallah. The gate of the dua is closed. We don't do it. We sit after the prayer. I challenge you, check yourself in the coming week. And see how long do you stay after the prayer. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, make dua. How long do we make dua? Do really the whiteness of our underarms shows? Do we really exaggerate the dua like Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam did? My dear Muslim brothers, our sisters in Syria are being raped. They're being raped, they're being tortured. You cannot imagine. I just came back from Jordan. Allah is my witness. I went to the Za'atra. There is a camp that was established in the desert, basically, on the border. Brothers, wallahi, the animals cannot live in it. It is so hot. It's so dusty. There is no electric running. There is no sewer. There is no water. Most of the people in that camp are children. Allah is my witness. I was there. I spent almost 4 or 5 hours in that camp. Most of them are children. If you were to take one child and try to wash him, you will take literally more than 2 or 3 pounds of dirt of the child falling from him. Those are the Muslims. Not Syrian doesn't mean anything. They are Muslims. They say, La ilaha illallah. Did you all forget in Ghazwat Tabuk, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he prepared an army in the fight of difficulty and gone from Medina all the way to Tabuk, a distance of 1 month, to revenge the death of two converts. Two Muslims who revert back to Islam were killed by the Ghassasina and Manadira, the Arabs who belong to Persia and Rome. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam prepares a major army with high number in the time of difficulty. There was a famine. There was not enough food even to eat. And he carries it. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he brags about it. He says, Nusirtu bil-ru'b masirata shahr. Allah gave me victory by the army, by the soldier of Allah, fear the distance of 1 month. Because, you know, the people who hurt the converts, they ran away. There was no fight. And Rasulullah conquered that area at that battle. So, my dear Muslim brothers, the situation requires dua. We need to have that feeling in our heart that what Allah has promised is there. Another description that we might lack. We need to have ثبات القلوب على موعود الله. We need to have affirmity in our hearts. Affirmity. Brothers, أقسم بالله العظيم, if you go through this earth from north to south and east to west, you will not find better than لا إله إلا الله. You will not find better teaching and guidance than the guidance of Rasulullah. You will not. Don't seek it from the east and the west. Don't seek it from the north and the south. Don't seek it from this one and that one. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he saw Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu in the early stage of this da'wah, holding a book of Torah, the Torah at that time, and he was reading it. He said, Ya Umar, what is that in your hand? He said, the Torah, Ya Rasulullah. He said, let go of it. Let go of it. Wallahi, if Musa is bayna adhurikum, between you, he will be a follower of mine. He will be a follower of mine. Nowadays, what's wrong with the Ummah? What's wrong with us? We're seeking it from everywhere except from the guidance of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We seek it from everywhere except the Quran that Allah has given us. هو الذي بعث في الأميين رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياته. He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who sent Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from among ourselves. We know him. We know him really well. 40 years he was among the Arabs in Mecca, known as Sadiq al-Amin. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his wife Khadija says, Wallahi innaka latu'inu al-madloom. By Allah, you are the one who assists the oppressed. By Allah, you are the one who gives the one who doesn't have. And that's before the da'wah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the best guidance. We have to have that thabat, that affirmity in our heart. Do not seek it from the east to west. Do not try to please others in the displeasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. من أرضى الله بسخط الناس رضي الله عنه وأرضى عنه الناس ومن أسخط الله برضى الناس سخط الله عليه وأسخط عليه الناس. Whoever pleases others
In the displeasure of Allah, Allah will be displeased with him and will make the people displeased with him. Look at us. Look at us. We are the ugly ducklings. We are the ugly. No matter how much we try, we still profiled. We are still not good enough. Can you imagine assisting the Muslims in one country and killing them in another country? What is wrong? Nowadays, they are assisting the Muslims in Egypt. Not the Muslims, the government. And no, they are assisting the Muslims in Syria. I'm talking about the Saudi government. And they are doing supporting the oppression in Egypt. It's crooked because they don't have the real essence of what is needed. إِنَّ هَذِهِ أُمَّتُكُمْ أُمَّةً وَاحِدَةً وَأَنَا رَبُّكُمْ فَاعْبُدُونَ. This ummah is one ummah, is not two ummah. The cries of my Muslim brother in Burma or in Indonesia or in Syria or Egypt or Libya is the same. It makes no difference. My heart should break for them. My heart should break for them. My hand should move. My tongue should try to give them victory after that oppression, after the oppression they are facing. So that's another one. Another one, my dear Muslim brothers, is حياة طيبة. Is تعظيم حرمات الله. You need to glorify the sacred boundaries of Allah. Stop the nonsense. I am so, sometimes I get so angry because I do have children. And nowadays, like, it's okay. Marijuana, they are trying to make it legal in some states. Brothers, it's haram. It's haram. If it's in your system, your prayer will not be accepted for 40 days until it removes 100% you remove it out of your system. Those youth, those young brothers nowadays, what is wrong with the ummah? What's wrong with the youth? Brothers, hold yourself in the masajid. Connect yourselves with the good Muslim brothers. A man who leads you to shaitan, to the hellfire is not your friend. Oh, he is my friend. No, we really don't go to the bars. Okay. But we smoke marijuana. We don't go to the bar. No, astaghfirullah. We would never do zina. But we have girlfriend. What's the standards? Got mixed up. تعظيم حرمات الله. We need to glorify the sacred boundaries of Allah. If Allah says it's haram, it is haram. We don't need to start always massaging it. Always putting some fragrance on it. Bira is haram. Khamr is haram with all its forms. Not only drinking it, sitting with the people who drink it. Going to the places that serve it. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, mal'oonun bil khamri sit. Six type of categories of people are cursed. And you know what the curse of Allah means? Kicking them out from the mercy of Allah. And once Allah kicks someone out of his mercy, he has no chance. ما يبدل القول لدي وما أنا بظلام للعبيد. The word will not be changed if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says it. That's why if he says I forgive you, you're lucky. Do not get the wrath of Allah. Do not get the anger of Allah. Snap out of it. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in the hadith, سبعة يضلهم الله في ظله يوم لا ظل إلا ظله. He talks about the seven who will be under the shade of Allah. Let's go over them, see what they are. Imam Adil, a just leader. That's for the ummah, right? What's the second one? وَشَابٌ نَشَىٰ عَلَىٰ طَاعَةِ اللَّهِ. A youth who was raised on the obedience of Allah. Subhanallah. Allah means everything to him. Allah means everything to him. Like when I stand with some of the youth, and I'm not talking about 8 and 9. I'm talking about 18 and 19 and 20 and 23, 24. And you tell them that, oh, it's just sunnah. Yeah, you don't need it. It's not good enough. How many of us nowadays do not make sunnah? After dhuhr prayer and after asr, after maghrib prayer, even the sunnah al-ratiba, how many of us? Like, it's not important enough. You guaranteed the fard? وَلَا يَزَالُ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلِ حَتَّى أُحِبَّهُ فَإِذَا أَحْبَبْتُهُ كُنْتُ سَمْعُهُ الَّذِي يَسْمَعُ بِهِ. And my servant will continue coming closer and closer to me until I, by the extras, by the nafila, until I love him.
And when I love him, I will be his eyes that he sees with, his ears that he hears with, his hand that he uses, his feet that he walks with. That means you become 100% guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Totally guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is شَابٌ نَشَأَ فِي... And then what's the other one? وَرَجُلٌ قَلْبُهُ مُعَلَّقٌ بِالْمَسَاجِدِ. A man whose heart is connected with the masajid. SubhanAllah. Two men who love each other because of Allah and dislike each other because of Allah. What does that mean? That means I'm going to love this brother because he reminds me of Allah. The minute I see him off, he's no longer my friend. Of course, I could be his friend to bring him back. But I don't accommodate his nonsense. You know, nowadays we try to accommodate. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, لَا يَكُنْ أَحَدُكُمْ إِمَّعَ. Do not be a follower. يقول أنا مع الناس إن أحسنوا أحسنت وإن أساءوا أسأت ولكن وطنوا أنفسكم إن أحسن الناس أن تحسنوا وإن أساءوا فلا تظلموا. He says, hold yourself firm. If people do good, do like them. If they do wrong, abstain, stay away from them. That's the guidance. So we need تعظيم حرمات الله عز وجل. We need to bring the boundaries of Allah to its fullest. كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Listen to this. لا يغضب إلا إذا انتهكت حرمة من حرمات الله. سبحان الله. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم will never get angry unless he sees a sacred boundary of Allah being violated. Then he will become a different person. He will become like a lion. His eyes will become red, defending the boundaries of Allah. My dear Muslim brothers and sisters, I pray to Allah that He will give us the Hayat Tayyiba, where we recognize these beautiful little meanings. It's not the quantity. Yeah, it's nice to have a nice house. It's nice to have a car. But if your house and your car is not going to put you into Jannah, لا خير في شيء. There is no good in something that the end of it is not going to be Jannah. And there is no evil in something that the end of it is going to be in hellfire. We need to be careful. We need to be really careful in picking and choosing and teaching our children and our daughters, our sons, our wife to learn these meanings. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. I would like to conclude with, I was reading one hadith Qudusi, and it's important for the time, because nowadays we so much, those of us, some of us really have no clue. Some of us, they just live their life, nothing changed. And even when they hear about the Muslims being afflicted in the world, they don't even turn the news on. It becomes like we got used to it. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says in one hadith, أنا الله لا إله إلا أنا ملك الملوك مالك الملك وملك الملوك قلوب الملوك بيدي وَإِنَّ الْعِبَادِ إِنْ أَطَاعُونِي حَوَّلْتُ قُلُوبَ مُلُوكِهِمْ عَلَيْهِمْ بِالرَّأْفَةِ وَالرَّحْمَةِ وَإِنَّ الْعِبَادِ إِنْ عَصَوْنِي حَوَّلْتُ قُلُوبَ مُلُوكِهِمْ عَلَيْهِمْ بِالسَّخَطِ وَالنَّقْمَةِ فَسَامُوهُمْ سُوءَ الْعَذَابِ لَا تُشْغِلُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ بِالدُّعَاءِ عَلَى مُلُوكِكُمْ وَلَكِنْ اشْغُلُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ بِذِكْرِي وَالتَّقَرُّبِ إِلَيَّ أَكْفِكُمْ مُلُوكَكُمْ. This is really the punchline, my dear Muslim brothers. Nowadays, the ummah is in a hardship. We're having hardship. Allah says in this hadith Qudus, He says, I am Allah. There is no God but me. He said, I am the King of Kings. I'm the owner of all the dominions of heaven and earth. Everything belongs to Allah. Believe me, everything belongs to Allah. He says, the hearts of the kings, of our leaders, are in the hands of Allah. He said, you, me and you, as long as you are in my obedience, and worshipping me and you do what is right toward Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, I will alter the hearts of your kings and fill it with love and mercy toward you. But as long as you disobey me, you live your life as I don't exist, I will increase the dislike and the hatred in the hearts of your kings, where they will punish you and they will hurt you. Then he, sallallahu subhanahu wa ta'ala, says, do not occupy yourself too much by making dua against your kings and your leaders. Increase your dua to me. I will suffice, and I will make your leaders come closer to you. Maybe this is a good solution. Let's ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, fill our hearts with your love. Ya Allah, bring our hearts to the level that you want. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it very clear in the Quran, وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ. We have not appreciated Allah the way he should be appreciated. Maybe we need to change a little bit. Maybe we need to connect more with Allah, so Allah will suffice for us and he will be enough for us in toward our kings. Please say Ameen after me. Allahumma ighfir lil mu'minina wal mu'minat wal muslimina wal muslimat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat. اللهم لا تدع لنا في هذا اليوم الفضيل ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا همّا إلا فرجته ولا دينا إلا قضيته ولا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا لك فيها رضا ولنا فيها صلاح إلا يسرتها يا رب العالمين. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولوالد والدينا ولأصحاب الحقوق علينا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم ألف بين قلوبنا، اللهم اجمعنا على ما تحب وترضى، اللهم نصرك الذي وعدت، اللهم انصر جندك وأحبابك في أرض الشام، اللهم انصر جندك وأحبابك في أرض الكنانة، اللهم انصر جندك وأحبابك في كل مكان يذكر فيه اسمك يا رب العالمين، يا رجاء السائلين، يا مؤمن الخائفين، أنت المقدم، أنت المؤخر، وأنت على كل شيء قدير. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. وأقم الصلاة. Forgive me, before the إقامة, I think our brother has one announcement, then you do the إقامة. جزاكم الله خيرا.
Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters. I'll make it a little quick. I know we're running a little bit late.